My life begins with my parents. My mother, Abina, was raped by an English sailor on route to Barbados, my homeland. Once she arrived, she was bought as a slave. When the master discovered she was pregnant, he decided she was useless and so gave her to Yao, who I'm recognized as my father. Yao and Abina made the best of their life together until my mother was about to be raped by their master. She stabbed him and was hung for it. Soon after, Yao committed suicide. From there, a Naga woman took me in, and she was well acquainted with the spiritual arts. The spiritual arts, or Obeah, is a practice of using the natural and spiritual world to guide, protect, and understand life. It could be used in both a dark and light form, but Mama Yaya used it for good. She was a healer and my protector. By the time Mama Yaya died, I had learned much about Obeah and was able to communicate with her spirit, as well as my mother's and Yao. They brought me comfort and kept me company while I lived here in this shack by the water. I helped those who suffer from physical ailments, yet most people feared me. Obeah is powerful, and so they feared what they did not know. But I was a good person. I was a healer. Soon I met a man named John Indian. He wanted me, and I wanted him. The spirits told me to stay away, but I did not listen. I went to meet John Indian at a party by the fire, and soon I was his. He wanted me to leave my life of freedom and Obeah. Against the warning of the spirits, I followed him. I followed him to his master, Susanna Endicott's home. There she treated me like a common slave, and I could not tolerate such abuse. But I had John Indian, and our passionate night made up for the day. On her deathbed, Susanna sold me and John Indian to Samuel Paris, and we were to leave for America. On the ship, I met the family I would serve, Elizabeth the wife, Betsy their daughter, and Abigail the niece. We arrived at our temporary home in Boston. I was not planning on using Obeah for others anymore, but Elizabeth was sick and she was so kind to me and I could not bear her suffering. I made do with the local herbs and continued to heal Elizabeth and Betsy as best I could. Samuel Paris was a cold, cruel man, and he filled me with fear. In Boston was the first time I heard the word witch. I saw one hanging from a tree. During this time, I also realized I was pregnant and I should do away with it. While there, I also met Judah White, Mama Yaya's friend, who taught me how to use the fruits of this new land for Obeah. I made friends with Betsy and Abigail, but Abigail did not trust completely. We arrived at Salem, and life continued as it did in Boston. Salem gave me a bad feeling, but life was not so terrible because I had John Indian. The girls at Salem were always in my kitchen, and I'd tell them stories. I sensed trouble with the girls. They were obsessed with people who were in league with the devil. Satan and witches was not something I understood or believed, yet the girls were convinced that witches and Satan were all around Salem. I only knew Obeah, the spiritual world, and healing. In Obeah, there is no devil, no witch, only good people and bad people. I gave Betsy a magic bath that was supposed to be our secret. Betsy got sick, and soon I discovered that she was telling all the other little girls everything I ever let her know about Obeah. They now made me their witch. And so did the people of Salem. I hated it here in Salem. Things were going to get really bad, and there was nothing I could do except be consoled by John Indian. Before I knew it, all the girls were accusing half the town of being witches. I was the first to be targeted. These Puritans were fearful people. Not so much of the devil, but of everything they didn't understand. They thought themselves too good for their God to let something bad happen. Yet they felt attacked and so used to their religion to say that any misfortune is the devil's work. These foolish Puritans. Everyone they disliked or was not like them was a witch. Mama Yaya had already assured me that I would survive, and survive I did. Obeah was protection. After being brutally attacked, John Indian convinced me to confess to dealing with the devil and to accuse other innocent people. He was right. I had saved my life but condemned others. I was imprisoned in Ipswich with another woman. There I met Hester, who was jailed for some nonsense. We talked about men, love, and sex. While I did not agree with all that she said, I would later on see she was right about men. They are not the sole reason for anything. I went back to Salem for my trial. I accused others and so saved myself. John Indian accused people too, and I realized he was not the same man I fell in love with. When I returned to jail, I did not find my friend. She hung herself. A year later, I was pardoned and let go. Then I was bought by a Jewish man named Benjamin Cohen Azevedo. His wife had died, leaving him and his children. I did not feel like his slave, but like his wife and friend. He let me practice Obeah and encouraged me to bring his wife's spirit forward. He did not call me a witch or think I was with the devil. He appreciated me for my gift and was a generous lover. Yet I was not happy. I wanted freedom. I wanted Barbados. Soon after, I learned that John Indian had a new woman, but I didn't care. The Puritans must have feared the Jew too, for they burned down his house. At this moment, he freed me to live my life as I pleased. I did not want to leave him, but I wanted to go home so badly. I was led on a ship because I was a witch. The captain thought that having a witch around would be a good idea. Practicing Obeah meant I was a witch to people. When I arrived at Barbados, I was treated like a powerful witch, not a wise woman of Obeah. Here another man, Christopher, tried to use me for my gift, but this time in war against the slaves. He soon became my lover, but it was purely physical. Later I discovered I was pregnant. This time the spirits told me to keep it. I'll admit, it was amusing to see Christopher talk about Obeah doing things that can't be done, like immortality. No one really understood my gift. Only the spirits of Mama Yaya and my parents knew the real Tituba, the real power. Anyway, I was in Barbados now and away from those Puritans. Yet the war was near. Iphigene, a young man I healed, had become very attached to me. He carefully planned an attack. The night that this attack was to take place, Iphigene and I embraced and will be our final night together. We were caught and I was hanged. Don't feel sorry for me, though. Now I am with Mama Yaya, Mother, and Yao. My unborn daughter was born to another woman. Her name is Samantha. As a spirit, I can help everyone and be loved by everyone. I continue to heal and protect those that need me. Doing this is what a true good Obeah woman does.
Traz a lenha pro fogão, vem fazer armação. Hoje é um dia de sol, alegria de coió, é curtir o verão.
Vem, magalenha, rojão, traz a lenha pro fogão, vem fazer armação. Hoje é um dia de sol, alegria de coió, é curtir o verão.